And to help with that, please welcome Ben McCaw, Narrative Director on Horizon Forbidden West.
Thanks, Matthijs, and hello to all our viewers. Horizon Forbidden West is set 1,000 years in Earth's future after a global catastrophe. People live on in primitive tribes, but they're no longer the dominant species. Giant, animal-like machines now roam the land, and they're extremely dangerous. The machines aren't the only threat in the Forbidden West. A strange red blight is spreading across the land, and it won't be long before it strangles all life. Aloy, our hero, is the only one who can stop the blight. But to do that, she and her companions will have to comb through the ruins of the old world to find the technology they need. In this quest, Aloy has sent her loyal friend Erend into the remains of San Francisco to find a crucial piece of technology. Erend encounters raiders from a rebel faction of the Tanakh tribe. They are vicious fighters, but even worse, they've acquired the power to override machines. To rescue Erend, Aloy winds up fighting them. But first, she must cross the ruins to reach their camp.
We face a lot of obstacles as we traverse the ruins of San Francisco. To overcome them, we've given Aloy some great new tools. Using the focus scanner, you can highlight spots that allow free climbing anywhere in the open world. The pull caster speeds up climbing and can get you quickly out of trouble. The shield wing allows you to safely descend from great heights or surprise enemies from above. With the diving mask, you can stay submerged as long as you like and take your time to plan a path around amphibious machines or boost through strong underwater currents. And to speed up overland travel, a variety of machines can be overridden and used as mounts or in combat. Combat in Horizon Forbidden West puts a strong emphasis on tactics and player choice. For close-range combat, the spear is an excellent option. There's a range of combos that have different uses and effects. Valor Surges add a unique set of special abilities, one of which can be used to knock back nearby enemies. The spear can be charged to create a high damage effect that can take down even the stronger enemies. A wide array of different weapons is quickly accessible via the weapon wheel. A slingshot with adhesive grenades to temporarily stall machines. Bows with arrows that can strip armor and expose weak spots. A powerful launcher that fires spikes that explode on impact. Smoke bombs to temporarily blind enemies. Or you can pick up weapons shot off from machines. The full game has many more unique weapons, and each of them can be upgraded on a workbench, but more on that another time. The player will need to be smart and creative and use all of the combat options we have shown to deal with a large variety of deadly machines. Sunwings in the sky, claw striders and tremor tusks on land, stepmoths in the water, even the seemingly harmless burrowers that you saw briefly swim by. They are all dangerous, and even more so when overridden by human rebels.
We've only scratched the surface of the rebel threat, as Aloy will fight them in many forms throughout the game. And to defeat them, she must explore the open world to uncover the secret behind their power, and how that secret is related to her quest to stop the Blight. And this is just one of the mysteries she'll unravel as her journey through the Forbidden West takes many twists and turns.
It's time to wrap it up. We will have more updates closer to launch, and everyone here at Guerrilla can't wait for you to experience the full game. Thank you for watching.